Namaste, dear students. In the last class, we were discussing about mean deviation itself, mean deviation problem, what and all we saw mean deviation from mean, median and mode in the case of raw data, ungrouped data, how to see, how to find. Similarly, mean deviation from mean, median, mean, median and mode also, right, in the case of discrete and continuous series. Continuous series, some more problems we will do. So, while finding mean deviation, first what we have to do? First we have to find if it is mean deviation from mean, means we have to find mean deviation, first mean itself, next mean deviation. If it is median, means first we have to find median, then mean deviation from median. Only the difference you have to see here is from which we have to calculate, that we have to compute. Formula remains same, only the difference is we are taking deviation from that particular measure of central tendency, isn't it? Then we saw the merits also. Merits means it is a well defined, then it is based on all the observations, unlike range or quartile deviation. In while finding range, we are finding only 50% observations, or it is based only on 50% observations. First 25 and last 25% observations we are omitting. In the range, only highest value and lowest value, the difference between only that two we are finding. So, that two measures are not based on all the values. A third measure is mean deviation. Mean deviation is based on all the values. Here we are computing deviation from each observation, isn't it? So, compared to range and quartile deviation, it is a better measure of dispersion. Hope you are doing the problems which we discuss here, go through textbook also if you have textbook, then in practical problems also, in practicals also we have so many problems, just go through the problems also, because more problems you do, you will be more clear with the concept. So, next measures of dispersion. Yesterday we did one problem, due to time limitation we couldn't complete it. So, today we will go to the same problem. So, compute mean deviation from mode, it is in the case of continuous series, remember, compute problem is compute mean deviation from mode, compute mean deviation from mode for data regarding, for the following data, enough, for the following data. So, data is about daily wages of workers, wages and number of persons, wages in rupees, number of persons, number of persons, wages 0 to 25, 25 to 50. 50 to 75, 75 to 100, 100 to 125, 125 to 150, 125 to 150. Next 10, 30, number of persons 10, 30, 40, 25, 20, last 15. See, this is the thing what we have to do. So, compute mean deviation from mode. They asked compute mean deviation from mode. So, first what we have to do? First we have to compute mode itself. How to find mode in the case of continuous frequency distribution? You know, which is the highest frequency we have to see? The corresponding class. See, in the discrete series we are finding directly which is the highest frequency, corresponding x value is our mode in the case of discrete series, but it is continuous. So, here class intervals comes, we have to apply the formula L plus L denote the lower limit of that modal class, then F1, F2, Fm, Fm means modal class frequency, the C means width of modal class. By applying that formula we will come to know about mode. So first we will do, see, solution. I'll write here only. So I'll write in wages, actually wages, and number of persons. Number of persons I'll write F as F itself. Wages in rupees. So it is 0 to 25, 25 to 50, 50 to 75, 75 to 100, 100 to 125, 125 to 150, 150. Observations are not observations, frequencies 30, 40, 25, 20, 15. Correct na? Next, what we have to do? We know that mean deviation from mode, the formula is this one. Mean deviation from mode equal to sigma f into mode x minus z divided by capital N, isn't it? So sigma f into mode x minus z. Remember here x denotes what? This is continuous frequency distribution which contains class intervals. So x denotes midpoint. We have to find the midpoints. Next, z means which one? Mode. Mode we have to compute. X minus z, mode x minus z we have to find. Modulus value or absolute value of x minus z means we have to compute. Capital N denote total frequency. That much things will be there. So we have to construct columns required for that. So wages. Next, mid x. Mid x is required. Mid x is midpoint of class intervals. Next, mode x minus z, that we have to compute. Next, last column, f into mode x minus z. This much columns are required. So mid x, first find mid x. 0 plus 25 divided by 2, 25 plus 50 divided by 2, upper limit plus lower limit divided by 2. So like that. So 0 plus 2, that is 12.5. 0 plus 25, 25. 25 divided by 2 is 12.5. 25 plus 50 divided by 2. So that is 37.5. Next, 62.5. This is 87.5. Next, 112.5. Next, 137.5. Correct na? Next, we have to compute mode. Mode we have to compute. What is the formula to find mode? This is mean deviation formula. So before that, I'll write mode here. Okay, mode. To find mode, first highest frequency. Highest frequency is which one? Highest frequency is yes, 40 is the highest frequency. This is our FM, highest frequency 40. F1 means frequency just above the modal class. Modal frequency ginta just mele iruva frequency F1, that is 30, and F2 is 25. F1 30, F2 25. Correct na? FM 40, F1 30, F2 is 25. Next, which one? L lower limit of modal class. I'll rub this one. Okay, this one I'll rub. Later we will write. Okay. This question also I will rub. So, next highest frequency F1, F2. Next, apply the formula Z equal to L plus C into FM minus F1 divided by 2FM minus F1 minus F2. Correct na? L denote lower limit of modal class. Highest frequency is 40, corresponding class is 50 to 75. Lower limit of this class is 50. So 50 plus C. C means width of modal class. Width of modal class, width of each class is here 25. So width of modal class also 25. So 25 into FM. FM means frequency of modal class, that is 40. Minus F1 30 divided by 2 into 40 minus 30 minus 25. Correct na? 50 plus 25 into 40 minus 30, how much? 10. 10 into 25, 250. Correct na? 2 fours are 8. 80 minus 30 minus 25, that is 25. 240s are 80. 80 minus 30 is 50. 50 minus 25 is 25. So here are 10 times 50 plus 10, that is 60. That is our mode. Mode equal to 60. So hope you know how to find mode. However, so mode while finding, we got the answer as 60. Next, what we have to do? You can write the unit for this mode equal to 60 rupees, that much rupees actually. Next, we have to find absolute value of x minus z. Means what? X denote midpoints, z denote mode. So x minus z, 12.5 minus 60 absolute value. Remember, no need to put signs, sign won't be there, positive, negative, nothing we have to put. So 12.5 minus 60, that is 47.5. Next, 37.5 minus 60, 62.5 minus 60, 87.5 minus 60, 112.5 minus 60, 137.5 minus 60. Everything we have to write, means just values, it doesn't contain any positive or negative signs, no need to put. So 47.5, after that 22.5, I'll write the answers only. 2.5, that is 62.5 minus 60, 2.5. next 27.5, 52.5, next 77.5, correct na? Next, f into mode x minus z, f into mode x minus z. F is a frequency, mode x minus z is this column. So second column into 1, 2, 3, 4. So second column into fourth column. 10 into 47.5, 30 into 22.5, 40 into 2.5, 25 into 27.5, like that we have to compute. So just do in the calculator, you will get the answer as 475, 675, next 100, next 687.5, next 1050, next 1162.5. So hope it is clear this much. Next, apply the formula. To apply the formula, we have to compute which and all. In the formula, it is a sigma f into mode x minus z divided by n. So f into x minus z total we have to find. Capital N also we have to find. Capital N means total frequency. So total frequency is 140. This is total frequency. This total also we have to find. I'll rub this one. So this is a So mean deviation from mode equal to sigma f into mode x minus z divided by capital N. That is sigma f into mode x minus z is 4150. This total, again I am telling this total, 475 plus 675 plus 100 plus 687.5 plus 1050 plus 1162.5. This total we have to compute, that is 4150. Capital N is 140. Okay. Answer is 4150 divided by 140, 29.6428. You can write the unit also. Unit is required because this is not a coefficient of mean deviation. This is just mean deviation from mode. Mean deviation from mode contains which one? Units. It contains units. So it is 29.6428. Hope it is clear. So for finding mode, we have to compute which and all. We have to compute first. We have to find the mode. We know that which is the highest frequency. Just go through that frequency. That is called FM, modal frequency. Next, the corresponding class is our modal class. L denote lower limit of modal class. F1 denote frequency just above the modal class. That is 30. And F2 denote frequency just below the modal class, that is 25. C denote width of modal class. Then apply the formula, we will get the mode. After that, mid x. Mid x means upper limit plus lower limit divided by 2. Next, if inclusive class interval given means first convert it into exclusive, then do. Then x minus z absolute value, again you remember that is absolute value. Absolute value means which doesn't contain any sign, isn't it? Next, f into mod x minus z. F denote frequency. We have to multiply by this one, 10 into frequency. So this is 29 point. Answer is just apply the formula and substitute the values. You have to put the sign if it is mean deviation. If it is coefficient means it is independent of units, of free of units. So next we will do some more problems. Next, mean deviation from, I told one of the properties of median is mean deviation is least when it is measured from a median, isn't it? If you compute mean deviation from a mean or mean deviation from a median or mean deviation from mode, three if you compute means, which one will be lowest or least one? Yes, it is mean deviation from a median and it is called the minimal property of a median. So we will do one problem, compute mean deviation from mean and median so that we can compare the data. See, mean de compute, second problem, compute mean deviation from mean and median. Compute mean deviation from mean and median from the following data. So it is age, number of children, age 0 to 2, 2 to 4, 4 to 6, 6 to 8, 8 to 10. Next 30, 50, 80, 30, 10. So, see in this problem, we can compare. We have to find mean deviation from mean and mean deviation from median also, right now. So, here we have to compute mean deviation from mean and median so that the values we can compare. We told the minimal property of median. So, in this problem, we will come to know. So, first we have to find mean deviation from mean, next median. In the same columns, in the same table we can construct how many columns are required, we can do that one. See here, solution. So age, I am writing it as a class interval, okay. Class interval means age itself. Number of children I am writing as F, frequency. Okay, next one column for mid-x. Mid-x is required. Next, see, we have to find mean deviation from mean and median, isn't it? So, in the direct method, what is the formula to calculate arithmetic mean? X bar equal to sigma fx divided by capital N, isn't it? So, f into x, one column for f into x. Next, see, one more thing you have to remember, we have to find mean deviation from median also. For that, we have to find median. to find median in the continuous series, we have to compute which one. Continuous series alli median hege calculate madudu, do you remember? Yes, we have to find the less than cumulative frequency. LCF is required. Next one, column 4, x minus x bar. Next, f into mod x minus x bar. Next, mod x minus m. Next, f into mod x minus m. This much columns are required. See, no need to hesitate for this much. Just remember the formula, so that if you remember the formula, once you remember the formula, definitely you will construct the columns required for that. So no need to worry for more columns, they are just what we did, the mean deviation from mean we found out, similarly mean deviation from median, we are clubbing that two, they asked together, so that this much columns are coming. So, first we will find which one, mean deviation from mean. For that we have to find a mean, isn't it? So, class interval 0 to 2, 2 to 4, 4 to 6, 6 to 8, 8 to 10. Here 30, 50, 80, 30, 10. Mid-dex, first we have to find a midpoint. 0 plus 2 divided by 1, that is 1. 2 plus 4 is 6, 6 divided by 2 is 3, here 5, here 7, here 9, f into x, to find arithmetic mean f into x, 30 into 1, how much? 30, 50 into 3, 150, 80 into 5, 400, right? 30 into 7, 210, 10 into 9, 90, correct na? LCF, LCF we will find later, before that, okay, LCF also we will find, so that we will do together. LCF means a frequency, added up frequencies, not to go for a mid-dex or fx or something, we have to go for a frequency. First frequency is 30 itself, 30 plus 50, 80, 80 plus 80, 160. 160 plus, correct na, 30, 30 plus 50, 80, 80 plus 80, 160, 160 plus 30, 190, 190 plus 10, how much? 200, correct na? Next, mod x minus x bar, to find this column, we have to compute arithmetic mean. See, I'll write here, x bar equal to sigma fx divided by capital N, sigma fx is f into x column, total 30 plus 150 plus 400 plus 210 plus 90, sigma f means this total, this total we got here LCF, that is 200, here it is f into x total is 880, okay, it is 880. So sigma fx is 880 divided by 200, capital N means total frequency is 200, 200 means I wrote this one only, LCF na last we are getting total frequency, that is 200. So 880 divided by 200, answer is 4.4, answer is 4.4. Next, what we have to do? Yes, we have to do mod x minus x bar. Remember, we have to take deviations of each observations from arithmetic mean, we have to ignore the signs. X minus x bar, x means midpoint, 1 minus 4.4, that is 3.4. Negative bandre, we are not putting the sign here, it is 1.4, next 3.6, next 2.6, next 4.6, clear na? So x minus x bar, 1 minus 4.4, 3 minus 4.4, 5 minus 4.4, 7 minus 4.4, 9 minus 4.4. The answers I wrote here. Next column is f into mod x minus x bar, means which one? This column into f, 3.4 into 30, next 1.4 into 50, 3.6 into 80, 2.6 into 30, 4.6 into 10. I will write the answers. F into mod 102 first one. 30 into 3.4. Next one is 70. Next one 288. Next one 78. Next 46. Yes, 46. That total we have to find. The total is 584. Hope it is clear. This much clear. Next we can apply the formula. Mean deviation. I'll write here. Mean deviation from mean equal to sigma f into mod x minus x bar divided by capital N. F into mod x minus x bar is 584 divided by capital N is 200. 584 divided by 200, answer is 2.92. Okay, clear na? 2.92. Next we have to find mean deviation from a median. To find mean deviation from median, what we have to do? Yes, we have to find a median first, isn't it? So I'll rub this one. See, mean, however you know, the simplest, by using the simplest method we found. So mean deviation from median we will find. Okay, median. To find the median, you know, capital N is required. Capital N is 200, then N by 2 is 100, LCF just greater than or equal to 100 is, how much, LCF just greater than or equal to 100 is, LCF is this one, that is 160. 160 is corresponding class is 4 to 6, 4 to 6 is our median class, 160. 4 to 6 is a median class. I will write here only. 4 to 6 is a Q2 class or median class. L means a lower limit of median class. F means a frequency of median class. Frequency of median class is a 4 to 6, 80. Next, CF is a 3. Okay, CF is a 3. C means width of median class. It is a, so I will write here median. Median equal to, median equal to L plus N by 2 minus CF into C divided by F. I will write the direct answer. L means lower limit of median class, 4 plus N by 2, N by 2 is 100 minus CF is 3 into C is 2 divided by F is a frequency, that is 80. Answer is 4.5. That is our median. We got the mean as a 4.4 and median is a 4.5. Correct na? 4.5. So F in mod x minus m, we have to find the next x minus m. X means midpoint. 1 minus 4.5, 3 minus 4.5, 5 minus 4.5, 7 minus 5. Next one, F into mod x minus m, 105, next 75, next 40, next 75, next 45. Total is 340 here, it is 340. Next, mean deviation from median. Apply the formula, substitute the values. See, I will rub this one, median we found. So mean deviation from median is, formula is, mean deviation from median equal to sigma f into mod x minus m divided by capital N. This total is 340 divided by capital N is 200. 340 divided by 200, answer is 1.7. That much, actually that much age, that much years. This one also that much years. Okay, from this, see which one is less? Mean deviation from mean is 2.92 and mean deviation from median is 1.7, isn't it? So mean deviation from mean is 2.92, it is 1.7. Which one is least? Yes, second one. So from this, we can conclude that mean deviation is least when it is measured from a median, isn't it? So we will, this is mean deviation from mean and median problem together. From this problem we will come to know that mean deviation is least when it is measured from a median. So this is today's class. Next we will do some more problems, mean deviation from mean and median in a continuous series. Then we will go one through the merits and demerits in the next class. Okay, thank you.